Welcome back, guys, to another episode of Grand Theft Auto 5 in first person. Goodness gracious, sometimes Trevor wakes up in the craziest place. What is going on right now? There are a bunch of dead guys. Trevor in his underwear. Wow, does he have poop stains? Pretty sure he's got poop stains in there. And a giant nice boat just chilling here. Ready for the taking, ripe for the taking. But it doesn't really matter because there's nothing that Trevor can do right now. Ooh, I've never driven a boat in first person in this game. Let's see what this is like. Oh, that's actually really cool. Look, when you slow down, and then when you speed up, you kind of like stand up to be able to see more. I like that, because you don't really drive a boat sitting down. It's pretty realistic. And it's really tough to see where we're going, which is also pretty realistic. But anyway, I don't think there's anything that Trevor can do on the map here. Nope. So let's go ahead and switch back to Franklin, because he has a mission tailing the architect that did the Union Depository. So we're going to get those files so we can find a way in. Actually, no, I think it's the FIB building that we're worried about.
It's Franklin, man. I'm following the architect.
All right. Don't fuck it up.
All right.
Here we go. Tell the architect and get the plans.
Hey, stupid! You can't be on here without a hat!
Yeah, thanks a lot.
Site inspection.
Thanks, man.
Architect on site.
Architect's got a nice car.
Anything we need to be worried about?
The only thing we're worried about is you changing the plans again. There's always scope for improvement. Always is.
Those idiots drilled the new caissons on the west side.
You're kidding me.
The bedrock ends there. We need caissons on the east side.
No drama. It's a government contract. You pay attention.
I ain't taking a fall for this screw-up.
It's a government contract. No one's taking a fall. Except the government.
Alright, so he's gonna take one of these elevators. We should probably take the other one, huh? Long enough to press it, geez.
Oh, look, it's the great Ortiz.
Study him and study him hard.
I was gonna wipe my ass on him.
That's the engineer's plans. Mine you treat like a religious text, remember?
Yeah, that's it.
The architect to give up the briefcase.
Who's there?
I think we did a good job of that. It wasn't so hard. And we're going down. Get out of here as fast as possible. Thanks for the hat again, dude. Oh, he's not in there. Alright, well, that was way easier than I remember it being. I think in our last playthrough of this game, I'm pretty sure we, shot the architect, and obviously that brought a whole bunch of bad juju our way. Cops came out and everything, so just punching him was the way to go.
y'all really ready to get down, y'all hit up our sister station with Sister Greer, the lowdown. That's what's cracking. I got y'all covered on the classics, but don't forget, Big Boy got y'all covered with the new hip-hop. We all part of the same soul conglomerationness. Yeah.
Weasel News.
Laszlo is just about to be on the news. That would have been fun to listen to. Oh well. All right. We got it, boys.
It's cracking.
Hey, you got him?
Of course I do, homie.
Here.
Thank you.
So, all good?
Sure, homie. So is this shit for real? We just gonna rob the FIB and be allowed to walk by your boys like that?
Yeah, I don't fucking know. Probably not. All right, Lester, what do you got?
I don't quite know yet. Give me a minute. I'm not a fucking computer. Oh. Oh. Oh, maybe I am. Here's what I think. We have two options. The new security software goes into containment mode in case of emergency, you know, earthquakes, mudslides, acts of God. So we could plant some fire bombs. They go bang, the emergency call goes out, we hijack it, show up as firemen, and then we grab the containment drive. Or we could hack the system on site. We'll go in by air. Hope we don't run into too much physical resistance.
Sounds relaxing. Either bombing our office ran by a division of corrupt government psychos or defeating one of the world's most complex security systems using our worthless-ass ninja skills, huh?
Yeah. Eeny, meeny, miny, mo.
If you favor the firebomb containment drive option, you'll go in with that janitor's ID you picked up. It'll be at night when most of the workers are off. You mop the place and plant the bombs where we need them.
Seriously? I got a mop?
Yeah, yeah, you really do. They'll clock you on the cameras if you're play-acting. You also need a fire truck to show up in when the bombs go off, and a getaway car stashed in a quiet place near the bureau so you can torch the truck and then get out. The car doesn't have to be anything special. There shouldn't be any heat.
Well, what about the other way, with the ninja skills?
Now, you choose that route, you won't be using the janitor's gear, but we had to cover all the bases. Your FIB paymasters will have to provide you with a chopper and a pilot. Now, you fly way up above the building, parachute in, and gain access through the roof here. Now, you'll need to be armed to the teeth, mind you, just in case the, shit goes down.
Mopping or parachuting? Wow, you're making this choice really difficult.
Now, Haynes has given us the leftover money from the Polito job to pull this mission, and the crew will be paid out of that. We keep the change. So, what's it gonna be?
Alright, well obviously the roof entry option B here, sounds like the cooler one, but we've already done that one in the previous playthrough when we played back on the 360, so we're going to go with A here, the fire crew, and see what this one's
so
all about.
So you do want to mop, okay? Well, you'll need a couple of gunmen. They'll go in with you as firemen. Everything goes to plan. They won't fire a single bullet, but you will be running into a burning high-rise with them, so consider that.
All right, couple of gunmen. Who do we want? I'm gonna go with
Daryl. Daryl
Jones.
Great things, to be honest, but you just might be able to do this with him.
And Norm Richards or Hugh Welsh. Actually, let's just go with Gustavo.
He's my go-to guy. I ain't changing that now.
Okay. That all look good to you? You are robbing the FIB here.
Looks good to me. I don't really care about my
have a winner.
My pay.
I'll make
it's not like we really need the money.
We're ready.
All right, shit, hit me.
You know, I'm still looking into that union depository gig. It's real interesting. But I don't know if we can do it without you-know-who.
Well, as long as he can't do it without us.
Gonna have to make up with Trevor at some point, Mike. No choice there. Alright, mission passed. Architect's plans. Looks good to me. Getaway vehicles required for this setup. I guess we could go get that right now, right? Just find a simple two-person getaway vehicle. I want something quick. You said we really didn't need something quick, but I'd like to have something a little nicer. Searching, searching, searching. See a suitable getaway vehicle? I want a Lambo. Let's go back to Michael's house and freaking get something nice. A motorcycle? How funny would that be? Frank and I hopping on a motorcycle to get out of there. We totally could use a motorcycle. Ooh, Tracy's calling us.
Hey, Sugar Plum.
Daddy, I'm in trouble.
What is it? Money? Drugs? Your mother.
There's this guy. He's been following me around.
Uh-oh. We'll come save you,
Where
sweetie.
Vinewood Plaza.
Okay, wait there.
He's been following me in my car, so let's just drive around and you can talk to him when he shows.
Oh, yeah. We'll talk.
Where are we going? This way. 0.6 miles. Finding a getaway car is going to be put on hold. We're going to go save our daughter. Okay.
Let's go find him.
We should try over at Hawaiian Snow for him.
You shouldn't have to pay taxes.
We're looking for a guy in a purple convertible. I don't remember what make.
Okay, I'll keep an eye out.
Thanks, Daddy.
Hey, what are dads for, huh?
Since one of those skate ramps up there? I've never seen those before.
Roof over your head, speaking to guys who ridicule you on TV. Is he here?
No, he's not around. We should try that motel opposite the big construction site.
Where'd you meet this guy?
At a signing.
What are you signing? A petition? You shouldn't have to take that credit.
Not credit. They shouldn't let old people drive cars.
You see him?
I don't think so. Maybe we should look over at Cluck and Bell. Rockford Plaza. I
do that?
Signing autographs at the expo.
People want to meet you after that video on Fame or Shame? We found this prick?
Not yet. Okay. Oh, how about going around the corner and back up the hill past Crocahoop?
My baby girl's a celebrity with her very own stalker.
You finally made it, Dad. You raise your kids in Rockford Hills.
Ah! Purple car! That's him! Fuck! He's on to you! Let's go!
Stop the stalker's car!
Yeah, Dad!
Hey, what are you running for, pal? Let's talk!
Seriously! I didn't know she already had a sugar daddy.
Oh, hell no.
Not so creepy when there's a grown man in the car.
I swear he was gonna do something, Dad.
Yeah, well, now we're the ones who are gonna do something. All kinds of things.
Am I supposed to kill him or what?
Hey, creepo. I'm her father, not a sugar daddy.
You've raised a great kid, Mr. Sucks. Very...
Wait, Mr. Sucks, is she in a porno?
I'm sorry this happened to you, baby.
SUXXX, like Tracy sucks. I want to shoot his tires, but I also don't want the cops to come after us, so we're just going to keep
ramming. She's a lovely young woman. You've done a great job.
Yeah, well, it's hard raising kids in this town. Come here, scumbag.
How are we supposed to stop him? I don't get it.
You got to get him, Dad. I can't live like this.
What are you living like?
I can't go out of the house. I can't go online. Oh, my God.
Is that what you wanted? Maybe we're supposed to stop him and then beat him up or something.
I can't believe you did that.
What? We had to be sure.
I just wanted you to speak to him.
This was infinitely more persuasive.
I never should have called you.
Look, there's a lot of sickos out there. I couldn't take the chance.
I know there are sickos out there. My dad is one of them.
Grow up, baby. It's time you got serious with your life. Yeah, I ain't perfect, but I...
Oh, my God! Gross!
But I love
him. I guess. He really scared me, but I didn't... What?
Well, then pretend it never happened. Like, I try not to think about exactly what aspect of your creative expression enamored him so much.
Okay, that's right. Denial kind of works for me.
Good. That's my girl. Now, please, try to make better choices.
We're not stopping. Not until they extradite me.
Thanks, Daddy! Bye!
I'm glad I could use my paternal rage productively for once.
Let's get lost in this music and do our best to forget the Vinewood...